Good morning, student. Today we will start the exercise 3.3 of class 10th, and we will solve the statement problem. How to form the equation? Well, to form the equation, some word we have to keep in our mind. Well, in statement problem, it is given more, it is given increase, it is given from now, it is given hence or add. For this, these words we have to use plus sign. Always use plus according to the statement. Unless, decrease, ago, before, exceed. Exceed, we can use plus or we can use minus. But here we will use as a minus, and we can use plus also. And how we will use plus, then I will tell you. Subtract, use minus sign. All these word in the statement is given, in the given is given, then you have to use minus sign. For times, if it is mentioned, then times we have to multiply. Times means use, multiply. For times, use, multiply means if it is given two times, two times mean two multiply, or we have to put two bracket, and all the helping verb. If helping verb is given in the statement problem, or the word is given become, B is C O M, become, we use equal to. Meaning statement problem, we use equal to in place of helping verb. And move to question number third, exercise 3.3. First part, listen carefully, check your book. From the pair of linear equation, means first you have to form the linear equation for the following problem and find their solution. First you form the linear equation into variable, means you have to form two equation and then find the solution, means value of x and value of y by substitution method. Mean you have to find out by the substitution method the value of x and value of y after forming the linear equation into variable. And the first part, difference, here is difference mean minus between two number is 26. Here is mentioned, what is mentioned? Difference of two number is 26. So that mean difference mean here we will use minus two number you don't know. So let x and y, the value which we don't know, we have to let mean unknown value. Here is difference, that we can say one number is larger and other number is smaller. It mean the difference mean minus of x and y, difference of x and y is mean here is equal to difference of these two number, difference of these two number means x minus y, difference of two number is equal to 26, whereas x and y are the two unknown variable we have to let one number be. How you can solve? Let one number be, one number is equal to x, one number mean larger value, other number is equal to y according to question, and the difference x minus y is equal to 26. It is your equation number first. And now second part. One number One number, and now second part is one number. What is one number? This one. One number. Is mean helping verb. Is mean equal to three times. Three times mean bracket or multiply. Bracket or multiplying. The other number. So here is one number. What is one number? X. Is mean equal to, here is this, 3 times multiply other number y. So it means x is equal to 3y, equation number second. And you have to solve by the method of substitution. From now it is better to take value of x, mean you have to put value of x from equation second in equation first. Now it is better to put value of x from equation second, put value of x in equation first. Now it is not compulsory that you have to solve, you have to find out the value of x or y from equation first. It is better to find, well, find is already given to x. X in equation second. What is x? X minus y is equal to 26. What is x? 3y. 3. Here is x is equal to this. This x. X. Here is x is 3. Y minus y is equal to 26. 2. 3y minus y. 3y minus y is equal to 2. Y is equal to 26. Y is equal to 26 upon 2. It is equal to 13. So y is equal to 13. And then put the value of y where? In equation second. In equation second. Put value of y is equal to 3 in equation second. What is second equation? X equal to 3y. X equal to 3. What is y? 13. X equal to 39. Then you have to write one number is equal to 39 and other number is 13. At last you have to write one number is equal to 39 and other number is 13. Is it clear? And question number second. The larger of two supplementary angle mean, what is the meaning of supplementary? You know it very well. The sum of two angle is 180. The larger of two supplementary angle mean one angle is larger, another angle is smaller. And here what is mentioned? Exceed the smaller by 18 degree. It means there is third, second part. Let larger angle is equal to x degree and smaller angle is equal to y. According to question, these two angles are supplementary. These angles are supplementary. Supplementary means 180. Mean x plus y. X plus y is equal to 180. Equation number first. And now the larger of the two supplementary angle. Which one is larger? X. Larger of two supplementary angle. Exceed minus smaller by 18. So it means second equation is larger x minus y is equal to 18. Equation number second. And we can solve also, larger number is 18 x is then smaller. We can write also in this form. Mean x equal to y plus 18. We can form also. And now find the value of x and y yourself. And you have to sort yourself. Third part you do yourself. This is in equation exercise 3.2. Fourth part. Third question, fourth part. The taxi charge and in a city consists of fixed charge. Fixed charge means when we want to go somewhere, we have to hire a taxi, and when we sit, there is a fixed charge which is taken by the taxi driver, because this condition is applied by the government. Means fixed charge is given to the taxi driver together with the charge distance covered in. And after this is a fixed charge you have to pay, and the remaining charge, how much distance you have to cover. So it means there are two charges at here. One is fixed charge, another is charge depend on how much distance you covered. So we have to assume what one? Two charges are there. Let fixed charge is equal to rupees x and distance covered. For a distance of 10 km, the charge paid 105. It means if I covered a 10 km distance, then I have to pay 105. And for a journey of 15 km, if I covered 15 km, then I have to charge 155. Then what is the fixed charge and charge per kilometer? So it means there are two charges. One is fixed charge, another is charge per kilometer is equal to rupees y, or you can say variable charge. Here I have to say this. A, if I sit on taxi, that will be the fixed charge, and before to cover some distance, I have to pay this fixed charge, and which is equal to x, and also I have to pay the charge which depend on the distance covered, A and B. If I cover a distance of 20 km, just fixed charge, that will be rupees 10. Example, if the fixed charge is rupees 10 and I cover a distance of 20 rupees, and the charge per kilometer, let we are assuming charge per kilometer is rupees 2, then how much I have to pay? Fixed charge I have to pay 10, fixed charge plus how much distance, charge per kilometer into my distance covered 10 plus charge per kilometer is 2 into my distance cover is 20. So how much I have to pay? 10 plus 40 is equal to 50 rupees. If I will cover the distance 10 or 15, then how much I have to pay for the same charge per kilometer? Per kilometer means for 1 kilometer the charge is rupees 2, and for 15 kilometer it means this is 2 rupees per kilometer. 2 into 15 and plus my fixed charge. 2 into 15 plus fixed charge is 10. We can solve. Means fixed charge plus 2 into 15. That will be 40. Is it clear? And now same we will do. Here is A, fixed charge. And this is B, distance covered. I don't know. This is fixed charge. And this is distance covered. Here is distance. And here is charge per kilometer. Is rupees 2. Now, first part is, for a distance of 10 kilometer, it means here I have to cover 10 kilometer. एंड चार्ज पर किलोमीटर इज रुपीज, सॉरी रुपीज वाई, पर किलोमीटर इज रुपीज वाई एंड फिक्स चार्ज इज एक्स, देन व्हाट इज द टोटल चार्ज? टोटल चार्ज, लिसन केयरफुली, टोटल चार्ज इज इक्वल टू, व्हाट इज द टोटल चार्ज? फिक्स चार्ज प्लस में चार्ज पर किलोमीटर, चार्ज पर किलोमीटर इनटू में डिस्टेंस कवर्ड, एंड नाउ फर्स्ट व्हाट इज द टोटल चार्जेस? टोटल चार्जेस गिवन टू अस 105, द फिक्स चार्जेस एक्स, टोटल चार्जेस 105 प्लस चार्ज पर किलोमीटर वाई, चार्ज पर किलोमीटर वाई इनटू डिस्टेंस कवर 10, 10 इनटू वाई, और वी कैन से एक्स प्लस 10y इज इक्वल टू 105, इट इज इक्वेशन नंबर फर्स्ट. एंड नाउ फॉर सेकंड इक्वेशन, दिस इज फॉर द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन एंड फॉर द सेकंड यू डू योरसेल्फ. फर्स्ट सेकंड इक्वेशन, फॉर ए जर्नी ऑफ 15 किलोमीटर, इट मीन नाउ द डिस्टेंस इज 15, हियर इज इक्वेशन ए एंड दिस इज रुपीज वाई एंड डिस्टेंस इज 15 एंड दिस इज फिक्स एक्स, व्हाट विल बी द इक्वेशन? एक्स प्लस 15y, x plus 15y. So second equation is x fixed charge plus charge per kilometer y. This is into distance covered. What is the distance covered? Is 15. Then is 15 into my 15 is equal to how much I have to pay? 155. Then generally we will write here is 15y. This is equation number second. And we can solve from first equation and second equation. And the last question is fifth part. Fraction, numerator and denominator, which contain fraction, numerator and denominator. This is the fifth part. Let fraction is equal to x upon y. It is numerator or it is denominator. Fraction become means, what is fraction? Now listen carefully. Fraction become means equal to how much? 9 upon me 11. When, and here is fraction, x upon y is equal to 9 upon 11. Fraction x upon y is equal to 9 upon 11 if 2 is added to both numerator and denominator. The fraction equal to 9 upon 2 11 if, listen carefully, if 2 is added to, fraction x upon y equal to 9 upon 11 if 2 is added to both numerator and denominator. Numerator and denominator means plus 2 numerator and plus 2 numerator. Is it clear? When 2 is added to both, then the fraction will be 9 upon 11. Means according to question, x plus 2 upon me y plus 2 is equal to 9 upon 11. Cross multiply. Now 11 will multiply to 11 bracket x plus 2 is equal to 9 bracket y plus 2. And I think you know, you have to open the bracket. Now you have to know 11 into x. What is your answer? 11x plus 11 into 2. 22 is equal to 9 into y, 9y plus 9 into 8, 18. And that will be, goes to right hand side. Or you can find 11x minus 9y, it is plus, and that will be negative sign, is equal to 18 minus 22. 11x minus 9y is equal to minus 4. Equation number first. And now the second part. If 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, 3 is added to both. If 3 is added to both, then the numerator. 3 is added to both, mean fraction x upon y. 3 is added to both numerator and denominator, means 3 is added to numerator and 3 is added to denominator, and the fraction will become to 5 upon 6. The fraction become 5 upon 6. Then again, it means second case. Again, according to question, yes, you can say first case or second case also. Again, x plus 3 upon me, y plus 3. 3 is added to both numerator and denominator. Fraction will be 5 upon me, 6. Cross multiply. Here is cross. Cross multiply. 6 bracket x plus 3 is equal to 5 bracket y plus 3. Open bracket. Here is 6x plus 18 is equal to 5y. This and this, you know it very well. This 5 multiply y plus me, 5 3 is 15 plus 6x. Here is plus, that will be minus, is equal to 15 minus 18. 6x minus 5y is equal to minus 3. Equation number second. And now solved. First equation is 11x minus 9y is equal to minus 4. 6x minus 5y is equal to minus 3. Equation number first. Equation number two, find the value of x and y and put it here. After finding, find, and then fraction is equal to x upon y, you have to put the value of x and y. And now complete question from exercise 3.3, question number second, third all part, third having the sixth part, and last part you have to form the equation, and all question I solved it, and I form the equation, and you have to find yourself, and one equation is left, and then you have to form equation yourself and find value of x and y. Be good day, be safe at home.